what you should do as part of your practice is in both studios. You don't know what studio you're going to end up in until next week, right? So the day of is when you figure out which studio you're going to be ready to do. You have to be ready to do it in either studio. So all of your stuff, two CDs, your SM57 radio commercial, and the cassette. There's only four things that you're going to play. All four of those two CDs, and one more piece of music when you talk in the front. All of those you need to try in each studio. You get that? So assign it to program, meter program, and see what level each thing has to be in order for your deal, right? Because this CD's player output is different from this CD player's output, and that room might be different than this room. So CD player 2, what you're going to play in there might need a level, say, minus 15. You would write that down, so when you come in and set up, you just put CD player 2 fader to minus 15, you're ready to go. You don't have to try anything that day, you should have it all rehearsed. Do you get that? CD player 1 may have to be all the way up, and you would know that ahead of time. Your mic, you're going to figure out where you like it to be, where that needs to be in this room compared to that room. The two mixers may be different. You have all that written down. The cassette as well. So your mixer might be set up like this. Okay? And you would write that down in your notes. You are totally allowed to come in with your notes and say when you set up, channel 1 goes here, channel 5 goes there, 6 goes there, 7 goes there, assign everything to program, patch what you have to patch, and you're ready to go. You should be sitting here twiddling your thumbs by the time I come in to say it's showtime. You get about 5 minutes to set up. You're pretty clear on that? All right. Take notes. Write down where all the faders go so the levels are going to be beautiful. If you do something in the middle of your show and all of a sudden you start something and the levels are way off, I take points away for that. But if you correct it, I give you the points back. So you can start with something really low or really high, as long as we can hear it. If the levels are wrong, I'll give you a bad grade. It's a 2-point deduction. But if you notice it and fix it, I cross the deduction off and you get it back. All right, here's how it goes. When your show starts, you will play a song of your choice off Ultra Edit as music under your talking. All right, so it's computer and you talking first. So wherever you're going to patch the computer, where do you want that? 5?
5.
And talking. So you're going to start with talking and computer. Computer is under you. It's not dominating. It's not full meter. That's where your voice goes. So when I cue you and say it's time to start, you're going to hit the computer for the music. You're going to talk over it. And that talking is your introduction. Hi, it's me. Here's my show. Here's what I'm about to do. Here's the song I'm about to play. Let's have fun. You talk until you play the first CD. So that's your introduction with music under it. When that's done, I would stop talking first, leave the music on a little bit, fade the music out, and before the music's totally faded out, I would hit CD 1. CD 1 is your first thing. Played in CD player number 1. Write that down. First thing you do is talk over music. Music under is from Ultra Edit.
So we're going to have to pick another song on the computer.
Yeah, but you play it right off the computer.
Yes.
Your second step is to play CD 1 in player number 1. Now, I don't know the titles of your songs. It doesn't matter if it's the wrong song, but I am going to see that you played it in CD player number 1 instead of CD player number 2. In that room, they are the opposite way around. You need to be ready for each room. Don't know which room you're going to do it in until that day. All right, the second element you do is talk between first CD and second CD. First CD ends, you open your mic back up, and you say, that was whatever song. Well, you say whatever you want. I really don't care what you say. Just keep talking. And then segue to the second CD, play the second CD. While CD 2 is playing, the mic should be shut off. Whenever music is playing, unless you're talking, your mic should be shut off. All right, after CD 2, do not talk. Go straight to your SM57 radio commercial. That's the next element.
Is there only background music in the first segment, or is it in between? Okay.
Just in the first segment. Now the wrinkle here is your SM57 radio commercial needs to be able to play on this computer and that computer, because you don't know which one you're going to have to use that day, right? So move your folder that has your SM57 radio commercial in it so it can be played from either machine. Don't mix it. I don't want to hear a mix. I want to see the whole thing up there played from Adobe Audition the way you set it up when I graded it. So in order, if you have to move it from here over to there, don't just move the session file. There's no media with that, right? You have to move the whole folder that contains all the media linked to the edit information. You want to be able to just hit the space bar and play that thing right from zero in the timeline the way you need it to play. And that's part of your practice too. That's just, that's a setup thing. Have it ready in both rooms. Okay, when the SM57 radio commercial is done, do not talk after that. Go straight to the cassette. Show you how to cue the cassette in a moment. When the cassette is playing, I am going to tell you your grade. I'll tabulate it very quickly, tell you your grade, and then I'm going to tell you to keep an eye on me. I'm going to leave the room and go into the next studio where the other person should be ready and waiting for me, going like this. I'm going to ask them if they're ready. If they're not, I'm going to give them about another 20 seconds. If they're still not ready, I'm going to tell them it's showtime anyway. You've got to go. At this point, I'm going to look into here and give you a cue. And when I cue you, you take the cassette, fade it down a little bit so you can talk over it. It will then be your background music for your sign-on. Don't fade it out. Just fade it down. And at this point, you're going to say whatever you want to say as a goodbye. Good luck to the next lob in the next room. Hope you enjoyed my show. If you didn't, you can sand or whatever. You can say anything you want. It's not going over the air, it's just going to the room down the hall. And then when you're done, your sign off, your music is still under. At this point, you can just gently fade it away, and at that point, I'm going to tell the next guy to hit it. I will be listening to you in there. Every time I'm wearing headphones, I'm listening to program. Both of these rooms are feeding the same program, both going over the air. Right?
So if this isn't faded down, you're going to hear it with the start of that if you don't fade it down.
Yep, don't screw the other guy by playing stuff when their show is on. Which means when you come in here to set up and you need to cue your cassette, that has to be done in the audition bus, not the program bus. Yeah? Otherwise, you're going to be, we're going to hear you setting up and practicing. We don't hear testing. 1, 2, 3. My level's okay. We don't hear that when the other person's show is on. Let me show you how to set up. Come in here, load all of your things. Get your audition program open, get Ultra Edit ready, get the song chosen that you want, right? I would start by setting everything to audition. Don't even go near program yet because the next guy's on the air. The person ahead of you should have cleared the board as soon as before they stepped away from it. All right, in the audition bus, you're going to set up your cassette. Here's how to do that. Let me back up on that. Let me show you how to play the CDs. Who has Robin? We're gonna listen to your music. All right, I'm just gonna practice over the audition bus. So I'm going to meter audition. I'm going to monitor audition. This is in no way going to go over the air because it's not going out program. All right, so just to make sure I get it all, I'm going to put everything into audition. I don't have to be careful that way. I'm just gonna put them all in. Everybody cool with that? All right, CD player number one. I want this music to come on instantly when I play it. So when it comes time to do my radio show, I want to push this and have music right there. But listen to what happens.
There's a second before.
There's a lot of seconds before that. Audition, why are we not hearing it? All right, so let me show you that again. If I press play, I don't have sound instantly.
About 4 seconds.
That's a lot of awkward dead air time. You lose 2 points for that. We want to hear stuff instantly. So in order to get that to play instantly, here's how you do it. You press play and press pause right away. So you press that button twice, wait for it to look like that. And now it will play within about a second. So as I hit this, it's going to be more instant.
You won't take points off of that, right?
That little bit of time is okay. You want to know how to totally keep yourself safe against those point losses? Keep talking until you hear music. Talk, talk, I'm talking, I press play, there's nothing there, I'm still talking, and okay, this is my show, and I hope you enjoy this song. And fade out the mic. Okay? Can't lose points that way, because you talked right into the music. Good for you. I could count it as a miscue, but you didn't stop and wait for nothing. Same thing over here, when you want this one to go, which is CD player one, it isn't there yet. So, same deal here, press play and then press pause and wait for it to look like that. Now it's ready to go. When you press play, it's way more instant. Good? There is a deal where these machines, if they sit and pause too long, will put themselves into stop, and you need, in your practice, you need to know how long that is. Because if you've got it paused and you're waiting for the 5 minutes over there to go by, and then the person comes in here and says, okay, go, and you're ready to play, and oops, it's in stop mode, and that can happen to you too, so be careful of that. All right, that's how to do the CDs. Ready to learn how to do the cassette? This one's even more tricky. All right, the cassette. Let's hear the cassette. I want to hear music now. Check out how long this one takes to come about. That's a long time.
8 seconds.
Long time. So how do you do it? Do you rewinding it? Is which is what we had. You press play. There's nothing there. There's nothing there. Here's how to do it. Watch me. As soon as you hear something, press stop. Then take the cassette out. Everybody see this? If you take the big reel and you spin it to the middle of the thing, turn that backwards a little bit, about a quarter turn, then you put it back in, you press pause, that thing's ready to go now. Watch this. Okay. That's how we want it to go. We don't want to hear someone say, here's a song. And then we're waiting 8 seconds or 10 seconds for the tune to finally come up on the tape. Everybody see that? That's really important. You need to do that before I come in the room, right? And you need to do that off the audition bus, because we don't want to hear you practicing, warming up when the other person's show is on the air. So in the audition bus, you're going to come in, cue your cassette. You need to hear this, right? I'll show you again. You need to hear this much. Right, and then you're going to take it out, and then you're going to back it up a little bit, and then you're going to put it back in, press pause, and now you don't need to care about it anymore. You can switch it to program. That one's ready to go. All right, you got everything cued. You got your stuff all ready. Now you're going to get out of audition all the way across and get into program all the way across, just so you know, you can't possibly miss one that way. And now you're sitting here ready, waiting to go. But do not have your microphone up, right? Because that's going to be live. You can turn your mic on and off this way if you'd like. However, we will hear that over the air. That's kind of annoying. I will give you an extra 2 points if you fade your mic down before you do that. And do it like this. If you're always switching with the fader down, I'll give you an extra 2 points for that. About that
every time.
No. That's a lot to think of. Don't think that you can come in here and just nail this without any practice. A lot of people think, I know how to play CDs, how hard could it be? I can play a cassette, duh. You just turn them all up, you turn them on, you talk, say whatever you want, how hard can it be? What happens is your brain shuts off because you're nervous. And like, I just tried to play CD1 over here and it was in the wrong channel. You might be used to that room. By the way, practice in both rooms because the racks are the other way around. The players are swapped.
Is that room ever going to be used?
No, it's only going to be in one of these two. Yeah. You know what to practice? Mm-hmm. I recommend you do this 6 times through before we have to get a grade on it. Do I care about patching? Let's see, there's going to be some patches in here when you start. Because I'm going to be wearing headphones that let me hear program, that I'll be able to hear what the next guy in the room is doing as well. I'll hear what the audience is hearing. You should, by the way, be plugged into this and listen to what you're doing in your board and not anything over there. Because if you plug into this instead and you try to listen to what's going on in program, you won't hear it. Because the only thing that's going to that is program. Did I say that? If you try to listen to audition, you won't hear it through that. All right. When you're done, you know, when I'm in the other room and I say, okay, you're done, and you sign off, and then you fade down and out, fade everything down, clear the board, grab your stuff, and give it to the next guy who will be saying, hurry up, get out of my way, I need to get ready.